And tonight we're learning more details about the 13th floor penthouse added to this condo that collapsed just about a week ago. Many in the building industry caution not to jump to any conclusions after the 2018 engineering report revealed major structural damage. ABC 27's investigative reporter Katie Legrone speaks to an engineer who did a walkthrough of this building last year and what he found.
Nearly 1 week to the hour later, the hunt carries on for victims, survivors, and answers.
It's been tough. I just want to emphasize that. It's been tough.
This video released by Miami-Dade Fire Rescue shows the monstrous mountain of rubble. Responders meticulously sifting through amid so many risks, inclement weather, with the odds of success dwindling each hour.
The number of deceased is at 16.
Off-site, there are few updates about the building's history. Newly released documents show 40 years ago, the tower's 13th floor penthouse addition fueled an order to immediately cease construction. It violated town code, but town council granted an exception. Many questions still center on this 2018 inspection report as part of the building's 40-year certification. Engineers found major structural damage from drainage issues in the garage and under the pool deck and abundant cracking.
I am 100% shocked. I think I may be more shocked than most people.
Shocked because structural engineer Jason Borden actually did a walkthrough of the South Tower in January of last year.
I spent about an hour on site, did a walkthrough with the property manager and with a resident who pointed out some issues that they knew about in the building that they felt would need to be addressed.
Including stucco deterioration, concrete cracking on balconies and in the parking garage. But Borden says nothing stood out.
I didn't see anything alarming or anything that made me feel unsafe in the building or what we've done in the past at other locations. If we see something, we will direct the owner to immediately put shoring, to immediately brace the situation to have it resolved to make it safe. And I didn't see anything that I felt necessitated that action.
For Borden, it was just the one visit. But watching it crumble a little over a year later has been difficult to comprehend.
In our understanding, buildings don't fall down, and when they do have failures, they give us time to address them. The fact that this came down in the manner that it did completely blows me away. I'm completely unprepared to deal with something like that.
While the focus remains rescue and recovery, a top priority for local, state, and federal investigators is how and why this tower fell. They are all now part of the forensic investigation into this deadly collapse, which we understand could also include reconstructing this building somewhere else to determine cause. Reporting in Surfside, Katie Legrone, back to you.